Good afternoon, folks, and thanks for joining us. My name is Tim Wheaton with Sports Key to MMA, and today we are joined by the top-ranked ONE Championship fighter, the Monkey God, Jared Brooks. How you doing today, man?
Man, I can't complain. I'm just heading to another strength conditioning practice and then hitting jiu-jitsu later, so it's going to be a fun, eventful day.
Man, that is absolutely awesome to hear. I got some questions for you. We will be breaking down 1X in just a few minutes, but there's some stuff I absolutely need to know. You were born in Indiana, moved to Michigan a little bit later on. There's a great lineage of wrestlers and MMA fighters from the Midwest, guys like Pat Miletich and Matt Hughes. What is with the Midwest that makes people just want to beat each other up?
I think there's really nothing to do, man. I think that we all just are some corn huskers and some baling hay hillbillies. So, yeah, there's not really much to do. We get into a lot of bar fights. we just train and fight a lot.
But let's jump right into it. Do you have any news for us upcoming regarding one Mr. Joshua Passio?
Well, right now we're in the mix of trying to find a fight no matter what. And I think that Josh is definitely on my list. Really, really good opponent in the past, few fights. So if they want to give me Josh, that would be great. But I'm thinking Bokan Masiane is next on menu.
This is a big scoop. This is a big deal, man. When are you getting back in there?
I don't want to announce anything before one. But yeah. It's gonna be very soon. It's gonna be very, very soon. And like I said, I can't wait to put Bokan on that grill and feed myself.
Dude, I absolutely love to hear it. So let's get into 1X. This is the ONE Championship 10th anniversary show coming up soon, March 26th. I'm excited for it. So what we're gonna do is play some word association. I'm gonna name a fighter, and you tell me, what's the first thing you think of that person? Let's jump right into it. Lito Adewang.
Explosive.
Yeah, absolutely. You have some experience with him, yeah?
Oh, yeah. Super explosive. Has great technique. I just shut all of his stuff down.
Yeah, absolutely. Do you think Team Lakai will eventually hire you as a wrestling coach? Because at this rate, you're going to out-wrestle everyone at Team Lakai.
I would actually enjoy that. I love traveling and I love Filipino people. Last time I was in Singapore, I got to actually hang out with Filipino people. So, I think it would be a cool match as far as me learning really good striking as well. That'd be really cool. Much respect to them, but I got to do what I got to do right now, baby.
That's exactly right. Out-wrestle him and then teach him how to wrestle later. I think that'd be awesome. Next fighter, Demetrius Johnson.
The best.
The GOAT.
The GOAT. Yeah, he's literally the best of all time.
So
can't get better than that guy.
Oh, man, absolutely. And one interesting thing this special rule is about, it's going to be three-minute rounds for MMA. He's expressed concern that 3 minutes might not be enough. You've got experience on the ground quite a bit. Is 3 minutes enough time to work?
I think 3 minutes is enough time to work, especially when you have somebody that's not as seasoned in wrestling as Ratang is. Ratang is a very tough opponent, and I don't know what he's working on as far as his grappling skill. I don't know who they've blown out there. I know that at Tiger Muay Thai they got some wrestling and stuff like that, but man, it's going to be a really, really big mismatch, in my opinion, as far as the grappling goes.
Yeah, I mean, he's one of the all-time greats. It's tough to catch up on grappling. It's like you're in a different league altogether. But let's move on to the next fighter, Angela Lee.
Angela, super diligent.
Tell us more a little bit about that.
I think that she's smart for a young fighter, has a lot of great qualities. She's flexible. She has heart. You know, knows when and not to get in exchanges. But, she's super tough.
And yeah, fun. She absolutely is. Oh, yeah, she's a ton. She's very exciting to watch as well. She's expressed concern about she feels a lot of pressure coming into this fight. You've headlined, you've fought internationally. How do you handle pressure when you're going into big fights?
I just think of it like, I mean, excuse my language, but I think of it like it ain't shit. I think of it as like another day. Like if I was to just get into an ordinary street fight on the street, that's how I think of it. It's like a knife fight. You know, I treat the guy's hands like they're knives, and you got to go in there like there's no excuses. Like there's, I mean, everybody before fights are like, oh, what if this happens? What if this happens? Well, it's gonna happen. No matter what, so you might as well just go with the flow and appreciate that you're fighting on a huge big martial arts stage.
Man, that is absolutely awesome. I love to hear it. It's quite the attitude that I'm saying, how do you handle pressure? And you say, I'm pretending that he has knives. Like, that doesn't help. This is the difference between MMA fighters and normal people. Like, I'm like, man, I don't get it. That sounds awful.
I think that that it's just part of me now, man, and there was one time where I was having anxiety before fights and stuff, but I've just learned so much throughout the field of not just succumbing to that pressure, you know?
Yeah, you got a lot of experience. That's true. Next fighter for you, I'm throwing at you, Shinya Aoki.
Ooh, go to submission.
Man, he's good, isn't he? So Shinya Aoki, he's broken bones before. With most of you grapplers, is there kind of a silent agreement that you wouldn't just go for it? Or if the opportunity arose, would you break some bones?
I mean, if it means ending the fight and not succumbing any more damage, then yeah, I'm definitely going to break an arm, a leg, a neck, if it comes down to it. That's life and death. And a lot of mixed martial artists don't understand that you could literally put your life on the line. It could be your last fight. So yeah, there's no holding back as far as breaking limbs.
Absolutely. And what about his opponent, Yoshihiro Akiyama?
Sekiyama, man, I love Sekiyama. I've loved him since the UFC. That's my really favorite fighter.
Man, he is awesome. He's fought from heroes. He's the ones on UFC 100. He's now on the 1X show. What an absolute legend this guy is, right? Like, and he's got a nickname, Sexyama. He's living the life.
Yeah, I mean, Andy's a male model, dude. He's got it going on. I mean, I don't know how much Kaylee's pulling over in Japan, but come to America, and girls will be jumping on.
Man, he is the coolest dude. I absolutely co-sign with you. My next boy, I'm gonna name for you, John Wayne Parr.
John Wayne Parr. I mean, you talk about one of the goats of Muay Thai or kickboxing. I got to fight on a card with John. I think that he is definitely one of the best of all time. Hopefully, he gets that 100th win here soon. Wish him nothing but the best, and wish him nothing but the best of luck. He has a full pedigree and a head, but his body is just coming to him, but. Hopefully, in this next fight, man, we can get that 100th win.
Man, and he's one of the nicest guys as well. Like, speaking to him in person, speaking to him in interviews, how is he such a nice guy, you know?
I think it's just all of how many times you've been humbled in the gym and, you know, outside of the gym. And the older fighter gets, you have to get humbled, man, or else it's going to be a very, very tough road in the gym and outside the gym. So, meeting Brian Parr was definitely one of the coolest moments I've had in mixed martial arts.
Man, that is awesome to hear. And Stamp Fairtex.
Yo, Stamp.
Can Stamp...
All they want.
But hey, Jared, they brought you on. They said, sit down with this guy and he's going to ask you questions and say what you think. They didn't say what not to say.
Yeah. <that's... laughs> I do think that Stamp is a really, really good Muay Thai fighter. I don't know if I would want to fight Stamp in Muay Thai. But before Stamp, I would fight Rodman in that mixed rule stuff. I don't know about straight Muay Thai. That'd be tough, but Rasheng fights a lot of string beans. I don't know, man. I mean, if Stamp said to me that if I won the Grand Prix in Muay Thai, yeah, that she'll go on a date with me. So, I mean, whoever's in that, in that little circle, I'm definitely down to get it.
Man, what if I had her on the other line and I was like, now calling in, we got, she's right here.
Hopefully she can, well, I might have to just pop up my Google Translate real quick and we can have ourselves a good conversation.
No, Stamp Fairtex is absolutely awesome. One of our favorite fighters. We're going to move forward into one of my favorites, Super Bond.
Superstar. Straight superstar.
Yeah. He is unreal how good he is, isn't he?
Oh, my God. He did to, was it Giorgio did that to?
Giorgio Petrosian, right?
Yeah, dude. That was the first time I watched Super Bond, and I was like, damn. Definitely watching the next fight.
Man, Super Bond is awesome. And last fighter for you, I'm going to name Rod Tang.
Yeah, Rod Tang, I'd say he's one of the best Muay Thai practitioners in the world. I think that's great word to do. He beat the likes of Jonathan Haggerty, and John is no slouch. Besides that, I don't think he's faced like crazy great, and I mean it's Muay Thai, completely different sport. I understand, but just seeing these guys and the way that he treats them, like I don't think I would get treated like that really with Rod Tang. I mean, not saying I wouldn't get beaten Muay Thai against him, but I feel like I would give him a little bit more fight, that's for sure. And I utmost respect to him, though. He's been doing his thing. He's got his own video game and shit. So Rod Tang is a gangster.
No, he really is. And he's also said after this fight, he might look at a future in MMA. If he switched over to MMA, would you give him a warm welcome?
I'm giving him a warm welcome. I mean, if Demetrius doesn't teach him a lesson in MMA, then I definitely will.
Absolutely awesome. I appreciate the time and breaking down the 1X card. I'm so excited for it. 10th anniversary is coming up on March 26th. Now, you got some folks to shout out, don't you, Jared? I got Mark Asmer. We got the Fight Doctor. We got Jerry Miller. We got Greenhouse, Walt Lake, Sean Weisenberger. Who did I miss? Who else do we need to shout out on the air, man?
Ooh, I'd like to shout out my dad and my mom. Those guys have raised the G, and they've been from the game since 93, so I just really want to thank them. I want to thank my brother as well. I want to thank my coaches, James Lee, Coach Glove, Guy Hart. Man, we're going to be stumping the game here in April, that's for sure.
That is absolutely awesome. Mr. Jared Brooks, I hugely appreciate your time. Enjoy the show, and we'll talk to you soon, sir.
Thank you, brother. I hope you have a good night.
Cheers, man.